Good morning all. Today we are going to discuss about binary coded decimal code. So what is this binary coded decimal code? The name itself telling that it is the binary coded decimal. That means whatever is the decimal digit is there, each digit is represented in the form of a binary. So each digit is represented by a nibble. What is the meaning of a nibble? Nibble is nothing but a set of 4 bits. That means each decimal value is represented by 4 bits. So then there are so many BCD codes that are available, like for example 8421, 2421, 5211, etc. These are the different codes. Out of these, only 8421 is the most dominant one. 8421 indicates the weights of the respective bit locations. So always we take this 8421 as the BCD code if it is not specified in the numerical. So we're using 4 bits or a nibble. We know that we can represent up to 2 to the power of 4, or we can represent using 16 symbols. Only 16 symbols can be represented, but out of 16, only because we know your decimal value varies from 0 to 9. So total how many symbols will be there? Only 10 symbols. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Only 10 symbols. So only 10 symbols are used here in BCD, and remaining symbols, that means 11 onwards, that means 10 onwards to 15, they are called as the invalid BCD symbols. So, where these BCD codes are used and why they are invalid and what to do in those cases, those things we are going to see in coming sections. So, this BCD is used even nowadays, is used in pocket calculators. So, your calculators uses this. Then, electronic counters. Digital voltmeters. Digital clocks. Etc. So all your portable devices uses this. Even the earlier versions of computers, they used to use this value of the BCD code. But as the BCD code is complex and the size of the string increases drastically, so that's why nowadays it is discarded for computers. But still it is used in your pocket calculators, electronic counters, digital voltmeters and digital clock, etc. These type of applications. Let us see what is a BCD code, how to represent it. So I am taking one example. Express the following numbers in BCD code. It is given 90, 1507 and 38.2. Let us see how to represent this. So to represent 90, so I told you each one is represented by a nibble. Nibble means a set of 4 bits. So this will become 000. 9 will be 1001. So this way I will represent. So this suffix we write as BCD to differentiate from binary. Similarly, 1507. How to represent this? Each one is represented by 4 bits. So this will be represented by 0001. So this way I get to represent. Similarly, 38.2. So 2 will be 0010. Point will be there. So this 8 will be 1000 and 3 will be 0011. So this way you have to represent. So let us now see how to do the BCD addition. Before going to the BCD addition, so let us see what are the steps, and those steps we will try to analyze when we are going to this. First one is, you have to add two numbers just using the binary addition, like the same way you do in binary addition, same way you have to do the addition. So whenever you do the addition, there are different conditions that may come. So whenever you are adding, if your 4 bit sum, because each number is represented by a nibble, if 4 bit sum is coming less than or equal to 9, it is valid BCD. Then there is no issue. But it can be greater than this. So if your 4 bit sum is greater than 9, it indicates it is invalid BCD. So you cannot represent with BCD. So how to convert to the valid BCD? So what you have to do, you have to add 6 to the result to get valid BCD. Because there are 6 invalid digits, so you have to add 6 to get the result. And when you are doing this addition, let us assume if a carry is generated, so you have to add it to next nibble. So next 4 digit set you can add it. So you will see the details in example, so don't worry even if you are not getting. So if carry is generated from nibble, value is less than 9, but carry is generated from the nibble. So in that case, again same procedure, you have to add 6 to the 4 bit nibble. You have to add the 4 bit nibble or 4 bit result. Then if carry generated, add to next nibble. So here the handwriting is not coming properly because I am writing on a touch screen, because it glides, pen glides there. That's why writing will be difficult. But you can get my material from the link below. So you can download from the link. I am providing the link for the material. So you will get all the written material from there. So please excuse me for my handwriting, because it is because of the gliding problem on the touch screen. So now the first one, I am taking one example, 3 to the base 10, I want to add to 4 to the base 10. So we know 3 plus 4 should be equal to 7. So let us see how to get using BCD. Using BCD, I will represent with 4 bits or a nibble. So this is one BCD. So similarly, 4 is also represented 0, 1, 0, 0 in BCD form. So I have to take the sum. So sum, I told you have to follow the normal procedure only. So 1, 1, 1, 0. So it is less than 9. So that means this is a valid BCD. So this is my result. There is no problem. Let us take another example. I am taking the example 6 plus 5. So 6 plus 5 will be equal to 11. So 6 is represented by 0, 1, 1, 0 in BCD, and 5 is represented as 0, 1, 0, 1. So if you take the sum, this becomes 1, 1, 1 plus 1 will become 0, 1. So you can see here this result is greater than 9. Whenever the result is greater than 9, it indicates it is an invalid BCD. So what I have to do, I have to add 6. So 6 will be equal to 0, 1, 1, 0 in binary. So I am adding this 6. So this becomes 1, 1 plus 1 is 0, then again 1 plus 1 is 0, again 1 plus 1 is 0 and 1. So one extra carry generated. So each 4 bits are combined together and represented. So this represents 1, 1. So your result is 1, 1 to the base 10. I hope you understand this. So here the result is greater than 9. So that's why I have added plus 6. So let us take another example. So I am taking 9 plus 8. So result should be 17 to the base 10. So 9 is represented by 1, 0, 0, 1 and 8 will be 1, 0, 0, 0. Right? So this one I want to add. So when you add this, it become 1, 0, 0, 1 plus 1 is 0 and one extra carry is generated. That extra carry will go to next label. So here this value is less than 9, but the carry is generated. The carry is generated means you have to add 6 to this. So 6 means you have to add 0, 1, 1, 0 only to this nibble from where the carry is generated. So when you add this, so this becomes, because here no need to add, 1, 1, 1, 0 and 1. So what is the value of this? This value is 7 and this value is 1. Okay, so the answer is 17 to the base 10. So in this way you have to calculate. Let us see another case. I want to add 15 plus 17. 15 plus 17 should be 32. How your calculator will do? 0, 0, 0, 1 is 1. 0, 1, 0, 1. And 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1. This way we have to do. So do the addition of this. If you do the addition, 1 plus 1 is 0. Again that 1 comes here, 1 plus 1 is 0. Again 1's come here, this will come here. So 1, 1. So this will become 1 plus 1 is 0, 1, 0, 0. This much came. So for this I have to add 6. So this becomes 0, 1, 1, 0. So when you add 6, so this will become 0, because this is greater than 9. Remember this, why I am adding. Whether it is greater than 9 or if a carry is generated from the nibble when you are doing the first addition, in both cases you have to add 6. That is the reason I am adding. So this becomes 0, 1, 0, 0. So this becomes 1, because the carry will come here. So this becomes 1, 0, 0. So even if the carry is generated in this case, we need not worry because already we have added 6. So 2, 3. So the answer will be 32 to the base 10. So let us see another case. So 18 plus 0, 8. So result should be 26. How your calculator do this? So your calculator will take this 0, 0, 0, 1. 8 is 1, 0, 0, 0. Similarly, this is 0, 0, 0, 0. 8 is 1, 0, 0, 0. When you are adding this, you will get it as 0, 0, 0. 1 plus 1 is 0 and the 1 is added. So carry is generated here. So whenever carry is generated, automatically we know we have to add 6 to this. I am writing immediately so that I will not forget. So now coming here again, 1 plus 1, 1 plus 1 becomes 0. So this becomes 1, 0, 0. Done. So now you add this. So this becomes 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0. So all these are valid. So both are valid BCD. So there is no issues. 26 to the base 10. 26 to the base 10. So let us now take another example to completely clarify the whatever doubts you have or what practical problems will come. So it is asked in the question. This is asked in some competitive exams. So it is asked, how many BCD corrections are required in the following BCD addition? In the following BCD addition. So it is given there, the BCD numbers are given 0100, 0010, 0110, and second number given is 0101, 0111, 0100. These are the two BCD digits we got. BCD numbers. So now I have to take the sum of these things and let us see how many BCD corrections will be required. So let us take the addition of this. So the addition will be, so 0 plus 0 is 0, this becomes 1, 1 plus 1 becomes 0, and this comes here, so this becomes 1010. Then again sum will be there, 1, 1 plus 1 is 0, so this 1 will be generated here, so the again 1 plus 1 will become 0, so this will be 1. So here also 1, 0, 1 plus 1 will become 0, and this becomes 1. So now let us check which are valid, which are not valid. So 1001, this is valid, this is valid, but 1010 is not valid. 1010 is coming to 10. So what we have to do, we have to add 6 to this. Here there is no problem, here there is no problem. So first correction is there, here 0110. So when you take the addition, 0, 1 plus 1 is 0, so 1 will carry here, so n plus 1 is 0, again 1 is carried here, 1 plus 1 is 0, so carry is generated here, this will be added here, so this becomes 1 plus 1 is 0, 1, 0, 1. Then this is same, 0, 1. So whenever the carry is generated, again you can see here, this is valid BCD, this is valid BCD, this is invalid. So again we have to add 6 to this. So 0, 1, 1, 0. Again this will be there, 0, 1 plus 1 is 0, again 1 plus 1 is 0, again 1 plus 1 is 0. So this will be added here. So this will become 0, 1, 0, 1. Again the problem, this is fine, but again here the problem is there. Again one more correction will be required. So this will become 0110. So when you add it, this becomes 0000, 0000, then this becomes 0, 1 plus 1 is 0. So 1 plus 1 is 0, again 1 plus 1 is 0, and 1 comes. So this value is the final one because all are valid BCDs. So this will become 0001. So this is my value. So here how many corrections are required in getting the final result? So to get the final result, I have done 1, 2 and 3. So total 3 corrections are done. I hope the BCD addition is completely clear to you and what is the reason why it is not used practically in the computers. Because the reason is whenever the invalid BCD is there, we have to go on adding 6 and this process continues and the process is very complex. But it is very simple to use in the case of the small portable calculators, electronic counters and other things, because each digit, each decimal value is represented by its equivalent binary, representation is very easy. That's why it is used in those cases. But for computers where you want the fast processing, we don't go for BCD codes. If you still have any queries, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer to your queries from there. Thank you. Thank you very much.